Hello, you're watching ProActive. I'm joined by Jeff Stusek. He's the CEO of Information Services Corporation. Jeff, nice to have you with us today.
Thanks for being here.
Well, Jeff, you're out with second quarter numbers, and they show a 44% rise in revenue, powered by your registry operations services segments and also your technology solutions business. Core earnings significantly higher as well. Before you take us through the numbers, maybe a bit of background about ISC for viewers who aren't familiar.
Sure. We're a public company trading on the TSX, and we became public through an IPO in 2013. Our history is we were a part of the government of Saskatchewan, and we ran registries, and we ran it really well. Ran them really well, and in 2013, the government sold 69% of its shares in the public market. And since then, we've taken that registry expertise that we continue to apply in a long-term contract in running the registries in Saskatchewan, what we were doing before, but now we have a long-term contract with the government of Saskatchewan. We've also grown the business and taken that registry technology experience and expertise and applied it in other spaces that help law firms and banks, financial institutions, car captives deal with regulatory and legal information. Law firms are, you know, always looking to register companies across Canada. What we've done is, and we also created a technology division because technology is at the core of running registries and helping companies with that. And so we have three business segments: the registry operations that we run in Saskatchewan, the services business that we have staff, you know, across the country in Toronto, Montreal, and in British Columbia that help businesses deal with regulatory information. That's our services segment, and our technology business, which is primarily, we acquired a business a number of years back in Ireland and have staff in Dublin, Ireland, that really focuses on building technology as it relates to registries and registry information. And so we really see ourselves as a world-class registry company that also deals in regulatory information.
Mm. Well, I mean, going back to those numbers, and I mentioned just a few of them, and that was revenue up 44%, EBITDA up 48%, adjusted EBITDA even higher. And those results built on an already strong performance last year and come despite the impact of COVID. So take us through operationally how you got there.
Sure. Well, one of the things that we've been talking a lot about ISC is it has a strong, robust nature about it. And COVID affected all of us, you know, across the globe. But the strength of ISC sort of pushed through. You know, in Saskatchewan, it's a monopoly-like service, and it continues to run, and we do a good job of that. We manage the costs of that business. What we've seen in Q1 and now in Q2 is strength in the Saskatchewan real estate economy that's showing through on the registry operations side. But in our services business, what we're seeing is a rejuvenation of the economy in Q1 and Q2. That's pretty common in, you know, across a number of businesses. But what we're also seeing is this new customer acquisition. We've been focusing on acquiring new customers and retaining customers. And now that the economy is finding its feet again, we're seeing that in the results. And so Q2 is really the strength of those so core businesses, if you will, both the real estate market rejuvenation in Saskatchewan, the economic rejuvenation in Canada, but also new customer acquisitions that we've been focusing on and keeping customers. And so our focus always is on having extremely satisfied customers, and we apply it across all three of the business segments. And that's what we're seeing. We're seeing strength and robustness in the business.
Jeff, were any projects put on hold or delayed due to COVID, and particularly in your technology solutions business, for instance?
Yeah, our technology solutions business, we really sell technology to governments and government-like organizations. Obviously, 2020 was tough as governments were focused on the right priorities: health, the economy, trying to keep their citizens safe, not as focused on you know, implementing new technology. And we're seeing some of that. We still have exciting projects that are, you know, well underway, and we continue to work on. We announced the Irish Aviation Authority project in 2019, where the safety and pilot medical record system, if you will, we're implementing for the Irish Aviation Authority, and that remains a good solid project for us, and we're excited about that and excited what we could do with that going forward as well. So it's not like we're, you know, tools down on the technology side, but you know, the number of opportunities, we're just a little bit delayed. And the current customers that we're working with had some sort of timing delays themselves because they were focused on other things. So we expect this is just timing. This quarter, we saw a little bit of an impact on the revenue side, on the technology piece, on the segment, but that's a smaller part of our business. And we expect that to come back shortly.
I mean, what's the outlook for those three main businesses for the remainder of the year? So kind of the third and fourth quarters.
Sure. We continue to feel positive about the businesses, the segments that we currently run in the areas we currently run them in. We made a decision not to issue official guidance this year just because of the uncertainty of COVID. We're, you know, still not positive about sort of the COVID and the variants, but we do remain confident in the business. This is a strong business. You could look back at it through the past four quarters and see the strength in the business. Q3, four of last year, Q1, two of this year, the business continues to perform remarkably well, above expectations. And so we expect that to continue going forward.
And of course, you are going ahead with a quarterly dividend as well, aren't you?
Yeah, the board, again, we announced yesterday that the board, we were paying a 20 cent dividend for the quarter, which has been, you know, our standard for every quarter since IPO, except, you know, in the first quarter, there was just because we started later in the month. But every quarter since has been a 20 cent dividend. It really speaks to the strength of the business, the high free cash flow, the really strong and stable balance sheet. And, it's just a reward, if you will, for, you know, acknowledging the investors and being part of the ride for us.
So keeping investors as well as customers happy, Jeff.
We're trying to do both all the time. Yes.
Jeff, I'm sure we'll be speaking to you again in the next quarter, but thanks very much for chatting to us today.
My pleasure. Thanks for having me.
That's Jeff Stusek. He's the CEO of Information Services Corporation.